إن الحمد لله إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. الحمد لله وكفى، والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى، لا سيما نبينا المصطفى ومن بسنته وآثاره اقتدى واقتفى واكتفى. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، فصلى الله عليه صلاة وسلاما يليقان بمقام سيد الأنبياء وإمام المرسلين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Believers, be mindful of Allah as He deserves and try your best to end your life in submission, in a state of submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Brothers and sisters, we all know that life is a test. We've heard this before, and I would like to borrow another analogy that life is a game. Not to downplay the test of life, but because many of us can relate to it. And like every game, there are series of micro decisions that you need to take in order to win the game, in order to avoid losing. I mean, just think about the Lions game last week. So, and like every game, the decisions are not, or these moments that add up, and these micro decisions are not created equal. Some of them are in the first quarter, some of them in the last quarter, some of them, there's a lot at stakes when you make those choices. And it is foolish to assume that you have to think about those micro decisions, when to take the shot, when to pass the ball. All of these micro decisions, they are not created in the moment. There are hours and weeks and months and years that go into the training and the mindset and the skill set before you make the right choice at the right time. So back to the game of life and the test of life, we all need to prepare ourselves to become better at what we do. And now, in our test as American Muslims living in America 2024, there's a lot at stakes. Many of us have been active when it comes to the events in Gaza. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them victory. May Allah give them relief. May Allah give them support. We understood that American Muslims, we stepped up to that challenge. Alhamdulillah, we've been doing a lot. But you have to understand that when it comes to activism, which is a topic and a theme that I've been actively researching over the past decade or so, we have in our Quran, we have a manual. We have a handbook for Muslim activists who want to make a difference in this world and to literally save the lives of those innocent civilians who are recording their own massacres, their live streaming their own death. There's no more evidence more than that. And still you see people here denying, disbelieving, funding, justifying for the massacres. So there's a lot we can do. Alhamdulillah, again, as inspired by our Muslim tradition, it's okay to learn about activism, about decision making, about project management, about media and marketing and communication from other sources. In Islam, we're open to that. But let's examine our own first. And when I reflect on the theme of Quranic activism, there's a very profound story in the Quran about the activism of a mu'min, a believer, from the family of Fir'aun. The story of Musa alayhi salam, famous story. I personally have shared, you know, bits and pieces of it in multiple parts of the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us and highlights some of those events. And this is from Surah Ghafir, Surah Al-Mu'min. When Fir'aun made an announcement to his community, when he told them, after killing many babies, after killing hundreds and thousands of babies from Banu Israel, but here's one of them, the same, you know, fear that Fir'aun had, one of them came after him, which is Musa alayhi salam. The story that we're talking about most likely happened after the event of As-Sahara, the magicians. So the background is, Musa brought his miracle, which was his stick, that proved to be real, to transform to a real snake. that ate all the fake magic that the magicians of the Pharaoh had. And now Musa is getting popularity. Now more people are hearing about Musa. Now there are probably protests in the palace of the Pharaoh, silent or evident, that this Musa is a big shot. This Musa is a big deal. Maybe he has a point. Maybe we should talk to him. Maybe we should give him a seat on the table. So among all of this, Pharaoh stood among his community, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that in the Quran.
وَقَالَ فِرْعَوْنُ ذَرُونِي أَقْتُلْ مُوسَى وَلْيَدْعُ رَبَّهُ إِنِّي أَخَافُ أَن يُبَدِّلَ دِينَكُمْ أَوْ أَن يُظْهِرَ فِي الْأَرْضِ الْفَسَادِ.
Pharaoh stood among his community and he gave a speech. He told them, allow me to kill Musa. Now Pharaoh doesn't need a permission to kill, not at all. Of course, he has been killing without any permission, actually. But it shows you that even the oppressors, they want this fake democracy. That we have these rules that we can change whenever we want, that we can, you know, adapt, that we can change the narrative. But he, even Pharaoh himself, was trying to get permission from the international community of his time and to win the PR game, which we all know that Israel has been losing lately due to our effort, due to your effort, your activism.
ذروني أقتل موسى وليدعو ربه. Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, he's not only highlighting the actual massacres and the battles that Pharaoh is fighting, but also the ideological battles.
When he said وليدعو ربه, Pharaoh meant, let him call upon his Lord. Let him make dua to his Lord. Maybe his Lord will save him. Allahu Akbar. What do we learn from here? Pharaoh is accusing every religious person who believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh, you believe in Allah? Well, let your Allah help you and stop the killing in Gaza. That's a question that we have all the time. Where is Allah from what's happening? And we have people who are losing their lives, and we have people who are losing their iman.
And by the way, those who are under the rubble in Gaza are not losing their iman. They are saying, حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنَعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. But those who are from the outside, they're asking, hey, where's Allah? Where's the divine intervention? Guess what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us this life, this game of life is not Jannah. It's not the final destination. Even some prophets were killed. So the fact that religiosity will mean safety and security in this life is a false notion. If you really want this life to be safe from any trouble, then you're wanting Jannah. So you better act up in this life.
ذروني أقتل موسى وليدعو ربه. See how he is attacking people's lives and attacking people's faith. And that's what the pharaohs of the time are doing also. They're trying to demolish and destroy our faith. Subhanallah. Pharaoh continues his speech.
إني أخاف أن يبدل دينكم. I'm afraid that he will change your deen, your way of life.
Does Pharaoh have a deen? Not at all. Pharaoh, all of his deen, religion, way of life, it's all about himself. His power, his authority.
إن فرعون علا في الأرض قال أنا ربكم الأعلى. He said, I am your supreme lord.
So Pharaoh doesn't have any deen, does not have any teachings. There's no like five daily prayers for the Pharaoh. Then why did he mention deen? Because again, all the oppressors, they can put something together and say, this is a state. They can gather some thugs together, steal the land from innocent people in 1948 and call that thing, that entity, a state. And give it a flag and what have you. This is not a state. So what the thugs of the time, what the pharaohs of the time are doing, Pharaoh has done it before.
إني أخاف أن يبدل دينكم أو أن يظهر في الأرض الفساد, or that Musa will spread corruption on earth.
Look at how the Quran is deep. Let's see how the Quran is really, the history is repeating itself. And you are hearing about the story from the Lord of the space and time. Allah is the one who has vision about past, present, and future. He is telling us, he's teaching us. If you want really make a change and move the needle on causes you care about, read the Quran. Get your inspiration and instruction from the Quran. When Pharaoh made the statement, Musa made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh, you're going to make dua? Where's action? I want action, not dua. Dua is action. Let's not have this false dichotomy. Oh, I want to make action and then make dua. No, you do them both. And Musa was the biggest example of a spiritual activist that you can think about. Musa made dua to Allah as he was planning. During the planning, he made dua to Allah.
وَقَالَ مُوسَى إِنِّي عُذْتُ بِرَبِّي وَرَبِّكُمْ مِنْ كُلِّ مُتَكَبِّرٍ لَا يُؤْمِنُ بِيَوْمِ الْحِسَابِ.
موسى made دعاء to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. I seek refuge in my Lord and your Lord from every متكبر, from every arrogant person or arrogant entity or arrogant system. لا يؤمن بيوم الحساب. He made دعاء to Allah. And in his دعاء, profound wording, he's telling himself, my Lord and your Lord is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is in control. So even the killing does not mean that Allah has abandoned us. أعوذ بالله. Don't you ever believe Fir'aun when he tries to shake your faith after he shook the houses in Gaza. إني عثت بربي وربكم. عمر المختار رحمه الله تعالى, the famous Mujahid of Libya. May Allah have mercy on his soul. When he was leading the resistance against the Italian invaders and colonizers in Libya, his followers were telling him when they heard that airplanes are going to go and bomb them. And that was in the early 19th century. So mashallah, humanity have invented airplanes and there's science and innovation. And what do we use it for? Killing civilians in Libya. That's what happens when you have technology, but you don't have iman, you don't have rahmah. That's another story. So Umar al-Mukhtar asked his followers, هذه الطائرات أتحلق فوق العرش أم تحت العرش؟ These airplanes, do they fly on top of the throne of Allah or under the throne of Allah? And rhetorical question, it's obvious. It is under the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he said, so whatever they do will not be outside of the control of Allah. Why should I fear them? Allahu Akbar. And that's what you see the people of Gaza saying. They don't fear. And people of Lebanon and Syria and Yemen and what have you. So Musa, إني عثت بربي وربكم من كل متكبر, from every arrogant person who does not believe in the afterlife. Again, Musa's activism, he is pinpointing the main issue. What's the main issue? People are asking, is it voting for this or that? It's not about the choice of vote, يا جماعة. Activism is not only political. There's media, there's education, there's identity, there's infrastructure, spiritual infrastructure. There's a lot to do when it comes to activism so that we move the needle on the causes we care about. من كل متكبر لا يؤمن بيوم الحساب. Musa understood in his dua that the problem is that these leaders on the front do not believe in an afterlife. And that's the biggest problem. When there's no belief, when there's no regards, when there's no accountability. And this is where our political activism and our spiritual activism, we have to return people back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, we enjoin the good. Yes, we call for ceasefire. Yes, we do this. Yes, we do that. However, we start first and foremost, or we return people back to da'wah. Because those who don't believe in the afterlife and accountability will always be subject to political money or lobbying or what have you. Musa made dua to Allah, إني عثت بربي وربكم. When Musa made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he did not know where the help of Allah will come from. You see a pattern in the story of Musa. He makes a dua, he ties his camel, meaning he works hard and plans, and he does everything within his human, within his human capacity. And then the response to the dua of Musa comes from a very unexpected position. A man from the family of Fir'aun. We don't know his name, but we know he was a man. Not a male, a man. من المؤمنين رجال صدقوا. In the Quran, there's a ذكر, أليس الذكر كالأنثى. The male is not the female, not the female. But we hear about a man. وقال رجل مؤمن من آل فرعون يكتم إيمانه أتقتلون رجلا أن يقول ربي الله. A man from the family of Fir'aun who used to hide his faith stood up and said, would you kill a man just because he said, my Lord is Allah? Where did this guy come from? From the dua of Musa. And he stood up and spoke truth to power. And all of a sudden in the Quran, you see two pages in the Quran, it's like the divine camera shifted from discussing Musa and Fir'aun to only talking about رجل مؤمن من آل فرعون. We don't know his name. We don't know how does he look like. We don't know if he had a plague about his activism or if he had a social media page with millions of followers. But Allah recorded his story in the Quran until the day of judgment. This is all a message. And where did this guy come from? From the dua of Musa. I dedicate this story to every Muslim American who's concerned about Palestine and who's asking himself or herself, My activism is not doing anything. Look at them, they are still being killed. Maybe a mother made dua to Allah before her house was bombed, before her 10 children were killed, before she herself was slaughtered. Maybe she made dua to Allah, إني عذت بربي وربكم من كل متكبر لا يؤمن بيوم الحساب. Maybe she made dua to Allah. Ya Allah, send me help. Send me soldiers that I don't know about. And maybe the answer to her dua is you. Your activism. Your awakening. You stand up and you leave that heedless life and saying, it's about time that I do something. Make a difference. Organize myself. Organize others. Do this, do that. Read, learn. وقال رجل مؤمن من آل فرعون يكتم إيمانه. Now there's no place to hide anymore. If you have been hiding, it's time to show up, to step up. أتقتلون رجلا. Would you kill a man? He said a man, رجلا, نكرة. Although he believes in Musa, he was smart. And wallahi, don't be a foolish friend to the cause. Wallahi, please. So many people, they think they are doing activism, but they have not slowed down and learned how you can influence the public opinion and the public relations and the media and communication. Just read a book or two. Just try to ask ChatGPT, how can I write this post in this way or that way? Just be a smart activist. أتقتلون رجلا أن يقول ربي الله. He is saying, my Lord is Allah. Musa said, ربي وربكم. So Musa is making dua, da'wah to them. He's preaching to them. And the statement was, he's saying his Lord is Allah. And he brought you all the evidence that you want. وَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ. That's why the scholars mentioned that this happened after the incident of the magicians. Look at the neutral activism. He did not side with Musa yet. وَإِيَّكُ كَاذِبًا فَعَلَيْهِ كَذِبُهُ. Wallahi, this is in the Quran. If he is a liar, then he will bear the consequences. وَإِيَّكُ صَادِقًا يُصِبْكُمْ بَعْضُ الَّذِي يَعِدُكُمْ. And if he is truthful, hey, it's too, maybe they're right. Maybe we're wrong. He's just being objective. Then you will be hurt by what he is promising. Subhanallah. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَهْدِي مَنْ هُوَ مُسْرِفٌ كَذَّابٌ. Now the religious tone is increasing in the speech of the believer. إِنَّ اللَّهَ, Allah does not guide those who are يعني, transgressors and who are liars. And now the activism, again, the Muslim handbook to change the word, read Surah Ghafir. يَا قَوْمِ لَكُمُ الْمُلْكُ الْيَوْمَ ظَاهِرِينَ فِي الْأَرْضِ. Oh my people, يَا اللَّهِ ضَعْ تَحْتَهَا أَلْفَ خَطْ. يَا قَوْمِ, my people. I'm not a double agent who works for Musa and Fir'aun. That's not my message. You are my people. I love you. I have all love and respect for your community, for our traditions, for what we stand for. Ya jama'ah, when we are active for Gaza, we are being active for America. Let us not shy away from this fact. No, we are trying really when we talk about peace and justice for all. We're telling America, look into the mirror and see what you're doing. Ya qawmi, my people. Lakumu al-mulku al-yawma zahirina fil ard. Today you are in control. Today you have the kingdom. When he was praising them, he said, لَكُمُ الْمُلْكُ. Look at the Quran and the beautiful eloquence of the Quran. لَكُمُ الْمُلْكُ الْيَوْمَ ظَاهِرِنَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. فَمَنْ يَنْصُرُنَا مِنْ بَأْسِ اللَّهِ إِنْ جَاءَنَا. Who's going to save us from the punishment of Allah if it comes to us? Allahu Akbar. He's caring about America. He's caring about the Fir'aunika, the Fir'aun institution. He's like, who's going to protect us? Because if we are on the side of the oppressor, we are going to be doomed. You guys have read the stories of Thamud and Ad, and he mentions this. Look at history. وَيَا قَوْمِ إِنِّي أَخَافُ عَلَيْكُمْ مِثْلَ يَوْمِ الْأَحْزَابِ. Allah, beautiful, eloquent speech that should be tudarras. How to approach a debate like this. It's not about debate. Sometimes we watch these videos and we want to win points in debate. It's not about that. Activism starts with empathy, with common ground. Hey, does it really help us to do this? Of course, Fir'aun did not say, خلاص, آمنت بالله. No. Fir'aun is Fir'aun. But there's a lot of silent observers who will be influenced, swing votes, who will be influenced, who will be mobilized by your activism. Never belittle your activism. Doesn't have to be in social media. Doesn't have to be millions of followers. It's about you internally understanding
that I have a responsibility. I could be or I am the answer of the dua of the oppressed. And if you in America cannot do something, then who in the world can do anything?
فرعون said, قال فرعون ما أريكم إلا ما أرى وما أهديكم إلا سبيل الرشاد.
I only tell you what I see. It's my way or the highway. وما أهديكم إلا سبيل الرشاد. I am the only one who guides you to the straight path. الله أعلم.
فرعون will always be فرعون. And don't be frustrated if فرعون is being فرعون, by the way. Ask yourself, am I going to step up and be the answer of the dua of the oppressed or not? أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فاستغفروه فيا فوز المستغفرين. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى لا سيما نبينا المصطفى ومن بسنته وآثاره اقتدى وقتفى واكتفى. The ayat are so profound, are so deep, and wallahi I'm not simplifying it, I'm not exaggerating. We could spend hours on understanding how the Quran can be a source of guidance and inspiration and action for our activism, for our human relationships, for our wisdom, for our applying for a job, anything, subhanAllah. Mu'min al-Fir'aun made the speech. He moved the hearts. He shook the ground under Fir'aun. And his speech shook the ground under the ground of every oppressor. Because every oppressor deep down are afraid from you waking up. From us as Muslims and other people of life, but especially Muslims. Going back to our tradition and be proud of it and not allow the war in Gaza to destroy our iman but to increase our iman. Subhanallah, sometimes if your iman is like a candle, every wind that will blow will extinguish that angle. But if your iman is like the fire of the forest, that's big, that's strong, the wind will keep it adding up and increasing and increasing and increasing. And if not now, that we as Muslims and young Muslims, we should stand up, then when? Mu'min al-Fir'aun, after he finished his speech, the last statement, and I'm skipping wallahi because there's so much to talk about. He told them, فَسَتَذْكُرُونَ مَا أَقُولُ لَكُمْ. You are going to remember what I'm saying. Imagine when you go talk to an oppressor or a supporter of an oppressor in their eyes. Hey, one day you will remember what I said. Just go deep down inside. And remember that decisions. Remember the videos and the evidence that you are ignoring. فَسَتَذْكُرُونَ مَا أَخُذُ لَكُمْ. And then he said, وَأُفَوِّضُ أَمْرِي إِلَى اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ بَصِيرٌ بِالْعِبَادِ. I delegate my affairs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I understand that my activism does not move the needle without the will of Allah, without the help of Allah. I'm doing the little thing, tying my camel. But this activism does not mean that results come from me. It comes from Allah. Allah is the change maker. Sorry, Mr. Activist, you are not a change maker. You are a slave of Allah who is supposed to do what they are commanded to do. Change comes from Allah. وَأُفَوِّدُ أَمْرِي إِلَى اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ بَصِيرٌ بِالْعِبَادِ فَوَقَاهُ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِ مَا مَكَرُوا. Allah protected him. And Allah will protect me and you, inshallah ta'ala. And if some harm will come your way because of your activism, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillah, I got the chance to be honored with some of the reward. Alhamdulillah that when people of Gaza stand up in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with their wounds, with their injuries, with their houses, with their children, when they sacrifice for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you can say, Ya Allah, I lost some money. I lost some business. I lost something for the sake of Allah. Wallahi, it's a karama to sacrifice something for the sake of Allah, and you realize that you are actually not sacrificing. Because Allah will take from one pocket, give you back in another pocket. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us help ourselves and help Muslims around the world. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك أن نضل أو نضل أو نزل أو نزل أو نظلم أو نظلم أو نجهل أو يجهل علينا. اللهم أصلح لنا ديننا الذي هو عصمة أمرنا وأصلح لنا دنيانا التي فيها معاشنا وأصلح لنا آخرتنا التي إليها معادنا
واجعل الحياة زيادة لنا في كل خير، واجعل الموت راحة لنا من كل شر، برحمتك يا رب العالمين. اللهم يا رب العزة انصر أهل غزة، يا رب العزة انصر أهل غزة، يا رب العزة انصر أهل غزة. اللهم كن معهم ولا تكن عليهم، وانصرهم ولا تنصر عليهم، واجعل لنا في نصرتهم أوفر الحظ والنصيب. اللهم أعنا على أن نغير ما بأنفسنا حتى تغير ما بنا. اللهم غير حالنا وحال المسلمين إلى أحسن يا رب العالمين. اللهم منزل الكتاب ومجري السحاب وهازم الأحزاب، اهزم أعداء الإسلام وانصرنا عليهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا، واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى، واهد الناس على أيدينا، واجعل الحياة زيادة لنا في كل خير، واجعل الموت راحة لنا من كل شر، واجعل آخر كلامنا من الدنيا شهادة أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد رسول الله. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. وأقم الصلاة، إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر.